First, thanks for being here. It's a little bit of a crazy day all around, so thanks for making a little bit of time to make it here. So we'll take a minute, just kind of review some of our objectives are to reflect on medium-term assessment data, identify strengths and opportunities for improvement, and then determine the story of the day we'll tell and identify possible data display. That's a little bit later. So, first, next on our agenda, they want us to share out some celebrations. Anyone have some celebrations besides the fact that you're here today, that you're not deathly sick because you're present? That's a celebration that we're here. Any other big celebrations?
We're seeing improvement with our sixth graders that are doing supplemental math.
That's fantastic improvement.
Seeing like you're more confidence too. So we teach supplemental math.
Oh.
So I got all of the sped and like our below second grade level kids. So
in just a couple months, she's going to have them ready for junior high.
That's the goal. But you're well on your way
to doing it.
Yes, we are definitely closer than before, and they're definitely more confident in some of those like basic skills. So I think that will help when we move on, that we can actually go through stuff a little bit quicker. So
I have 8 students who know their multiplication facts.
They pass.
That's a great thing.
I put it in their file, so I have proof for 6th grade.
They knew.
So how many?
8.
Oh.
Hey,
good.
Good
celebrations. Just as a reminder of the roles I'll facilitate today, Jamie, if you'll record, Candy, if you'll be our timekeeper today, keep us on track.
I'll do my best.
That's a task.
I don't know if I'm the right person for that job.
It's a task some days. Okay, and so each of you have taken some time to prepare. You have 2 different documents. One is this document, which is what you have all submitted. As far as where you're at in the instructional cycles, what you've done this year. And then you also have this document, which are the SAGE assessments which have been given. Really, our purpose today is to kind of look at our data. If you'll take 5 minutes, just review it individually. There's lots of information here. And then after that, we're going to talk about what you've seen and maybe some trends that we've identified. So let's take 5 minutes, review that individually, and then we'll have those conversations. Any questions about these papers before?
We have some
assessment data that we've gone through and reviewed, both our interim cycle, our instructional cycles, as well as all of the SAGE assessments that we've administered so far this year. So we got to the point where we reviewed them individually. Just wanted to go around the table. Take 30 seconds and kind of explain a trend that you saw. And if you'll just share one thing that you saw, what that be. We'll start with Whitney, so we'll get put that in the table to start. Okay. You get to choose which way after that.
Oh, okay. Sounds good. One thing I noticed just in each individual cycle was that they kind of build on each other. We looked at the results of the cycle 1, especially I noticed in the ELA, and it kind of determined what the next cycle is going to be about. They all played up on each other. That's one thing I noticed.
Which way are you going?
Okay.
I feel like in every subject though, there's like one area where students struggle with more than others. Like no matter what it was, whether it was ELA or math. It's very clear to see what the kids do know really well and where they struggle, which is good for us to know, because then instead of like maybe going on to a new cycle, going over something again.
I don't know that you can call it a trend, but about half of it, one of the things is why do you think these trends exist is the kids are rushing through things. They don't put forth the effort. They just want to hurry and get done and make silly errors.
Stephanie.
That was what I noticed too, specifically in 4th and 5th grade, and in writing. But the other thing that, I don't know if it's a trend either, but I just found it interesting how on that full interim that 3rd and 4th gave, the kids were only 34% and 29% proficient. So it's a really low starting point, which is not bad. Just I found it interesting that they were so close at the beginning of the year.
When did you take yours?
I'd have to look at what date it was, but it was pretty early. It was one of the first ones. I think ours might have been before that, but I can double check if you want to know.
Kenny.
I think I'm seeing a trend of where there could be increased vocabulary instruction. Like, some students don't fully understand mathematical terms, they sit for one of them, and the informational text that they're using a lot. I wonder if, that's probably not fully addressed, but I wonder if there needs to be a little more vocabulary instruction, or at least more concerted vocabulary instruction.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, it does. I noticed that people that are using the benchmarks, when they use them as pre-tests and post-tests, there seems to be a significant improvement, is a trend I saw.
I also picked up on the rush and I didn't care, but I tied it into a comment that was made about students having a hard time with their self-assessments, you know, that metacognition of being able to express where they are, and I thought as we increase our use of rubrics and have the students be able to literally check off each element of a rubric, I thought it might help alleviate both of those.
I didn't see much of a trend in, as far as the numbers. I was looking more at the percentages, hoping to see an increase in percentage. And I did notice, though, that we were pretty consistent. I mean, some went up a little, some went down a little. But overall, we at least maintained, if not improved, in general.
I was trying to find fall versus winter interim, and I think we're probably still waiting on the winter, but the one that I did find went up significantly.
I'm the same thing as Jade about the benchmarks, and this is the first time I've started to do benchmarks, and so my kids are going to start taking their second round of benchmarks. So it's nice because I was able to find what they're struggling with and use that test to make similar questions that we can practice with. So this gives me a lot of hope that next round is going to be that much better because I'm preparing for them. So.
I was just reading comments and see kind of a lot of rushing through their work and not reading some questions carefully and not being able to restate what they read. So I don't know. I'm just thinking, I wonder if sometimes we need to slow down. Why are they feeling like they have to rush through their work? I don't know the answer, but we've really slowed down with complete sentences, and we're just kind of staying with complete and compound sentences for weeks, but I think it's been really good. I think sometimes maybe we feel like we have to move on when they're not quite ready.
On that same note, like when she was talking about like them not reading the questions, so far, like something that I've been trying to do better with my kids is testing and strategies as well. Like we talked about, okay, if you're doing a multiple choice one, first off, are they asking you to fill in, like, is there more than one right answer, or are you just filling one right answer? And then, like, the process of elimination. And I think that would help a lot if we focus too on testing and strategies and read the question, go back to the story, then go back to your question. And, you know, they can't use their knowledge if they don't know how to take the test. So it's important to go over tools and stuff, too. I know it's important for third grade because it's their first year of doing it, but
the biggest thing
that
is they'll answer one that's true, but it's not answering the question. So there'll be two that are true, and then
it's not. We're kind of jumping a little ahead. Just a little bit. No, that's okay. I like those ideas.
I have one more trend that goes with what you guys said. I see that not everybody is taking it. So you're saying, like in fourth grade, 22 kids took this? That's not even one entire class. 24, 50, 68. Still, that's not everybody. So a trend is we're not all using them consistently.
That is a trend.
So your before and after isn't as valid because it's not everything.